Okay, hi, I'm John Lewis. And again, we're going to simplify the process of reaching people with the gospel. We're going to take our outreach and we're going to put it into meaningful categories. I believe that there are five forms of evangelistic outreach. I sometimes use the word evangelism because evangelism biblically is the process of reaching people with the gospel. My goal in life for the last 30 years has been to reach unchurched people with the gospel. Biblically, I'm an evangelist, but that word has taken on a different meaning in the media and other places like that. So sometimes I'm a little reluctant to use it, but that's the context. Evangelism, the process of reaching people who do not know Christ with the gospel to see them come to know Christ. There's actually seven forms of evangelism, but I believe there's five that we want to focus on. The first is prayer, praying for people, praying for our unchurched friends. The second is preaching and proclamation and teaching. This is teaching, this is preaching, this is a revival. This is Bill Bright's Four Spiritual Laws. This is a Bible tract put in a restroom somewhere that people can read. The second form of evangelism is the clear articulation in the written word or in the spoken word of the gospel. The third is friendship evangelism, ministries that try to reach out to people on a personal level. Maybe you've heard of small group or cell group ministry. That's what number three is. So if your church has a Sunday school that you want to reach people with, if your church has a small group or a cell group that you think I'm going to reach people in my community with, that's the third form of evangelism. The fourth is needs evangelism, meeting people's needs. For instance, when Jesus says in the parable of the sheep and the goats, whatever you do to the least of my brother, you do to me. That's what he was talking about. There's so many different ways to do that. I myself have run a food bank through my local community for, I believe, 5 years now, and I've given away thousands of bags of grocery, but that's one. I've known many churches that have AA that meet in their church, that's two. But they meet people's needs, but they do it in a way to reach them with the gospel. The fifth is the way that I specialize in, and that's arts and entertainment. Why did Jesus preach in parables, stories? See, Jesus didn't stand there in immaculate white robe with his finger in the air preaching in King James English. No, he was probably a very active and dynamic and enthralling storyteller. Jesus knew that if people see it, they'll remember it more than if they just hear it. God gave us the ability to appreciate the arts, and we should use that ability to honor him, to praise him, and to witness for him. So those are the five things. Now, I want you to understand, a lot of times people lose that focus. And when they lose that focus, too often they fall into this open-ended spirituality. They'll say, our church is not about a program. Our church is about building lives. Or we're not about another program or just trying to impress God by what we can do. We're about lifting up his name and letting him have his way with us. In other words, they keep it very open-ended, very non-specific. The focus is doing what we've always been doing. And I'm sure you've heard the statement that insanity is doing the same thing you've always done, the same way you've always done it, and expecting different results. And you probably heard the statement that says, if you don't know where you're going, any road will take you there. If we want to see our churches grow, if we want to see our churches reach our community, if we want to see our churches be the witness God wants his church to be, we have to begin to develop specific plans. And the Holy Spirit wants us to do that. The Holy Spirit says that to us. In Jeremiah 29, verse 11, God speaks and he says, I know the plans that I have for you, says the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. God has a plan It's there right now. And he invites us to join him. He's not impressed with what we know, but he has a plan and he wants us to join him. And it's always a specific plan. Moses didn't go into Pharaoh and say, I want you to love the Lord. I want you to be more godly. No, he said, let my people go. David didn't go out before Goliath and said, you really need to be more godly. You really need to be more like Jehovah. No, he said, you are opposing God and I know what I'm supposed to do. Every time when God called the 12 disciples, the 12 apostles, he didn't say, let's just sit here and have church all day. No, he sent them out with specific instructions. And that's the key. God has a plan for your church. And when you begin to keep your focus and you're consistent, then he begins to reveal himself in your life. So once again, please do me a favor, like and subscribe. That's what keeps us going. And if you'd like, visit my website, www.johnlouis.net, or go to YouTube and look up John Lewis promotional video to see a little bit more about what I do. Thank you, and we'll see you the next video.